Hi guys, it's Grace Pamela at Samarana.com, and I'm going to show you how to apply a balloon overlays using actions and brushes. Okay, so the first thing you're going to want to do is you're going to want to make sure everything is in place and ready to go. You're going to want to install your balloon overlay action collection, and you're also going to want to have your balloon brushes ready to go. Okay, so the first thing you're going to want to do is select Apply Balloon Overlay and select play. So here I have my balloon overlays here. These are more smoother, not so harsh catchlight balloon overlays, and then these have studio catchlights for you. If you're using them in studio, you can use them if you'd like. I'm also going to show you how to apply your own catchlight just in case. So I'm going to go ahead and select one and select place. You can adjust it however you see fit, and then select the check mark up here. Now, you want to make sure that you're either holding the shift key or not, depending on your settings, or select this link here, and that will help maintain your proportions. Otherwise, it might get a little wonky. Unless you want it to be a different shape, then you're more than welcome to do that. Okay, select the check mark when you're finished. And here you have your balloon resizer rotator actions where you can flip it if you'd like. Okay, so now we have our balloon overlay. The next thing we're going to do is we are going to edit our balloon, and I'm just going to quickly show you how some of these work. One of the main ones is smooth out catchlights. That's one of my favorite ones. So I'm going to show you on a different one with the studio catchlight. Now keep in mind your balloons won't just pop up when you press place. You'll have to search for where you downloaded and unzipped your balloon overlays on your computer. So I have mine here. So I already opened one up, so that's why it's popping up. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and select one of these. Check mark. Okay, so now I'm going to go press play on smooth out catchlights. You want to make sure you have your actual balloon overlay that you want to edit. If you select this one, it will edit that one. So you want to make sure you have the actual balloon there. Okay, so now I'm going to paint with a white soft brush. Here's my brush right here. And you can go up here and adjust the hardness if you'd like. And make sure you have a soft round brush. And we want to paint in the black layer mask, because black hides the effect that I have applied here. And white helps reveal that effect. So I'm going to go ahead and paint over where I want it. So now keep in mind, this also helps with color banding as well, if you have any from changing the balloon color or anything like that. Keep in mind, this was meant to play several times depending on how harsh you want the effect to be. So when you're done with it, even if you only want this, I recommend merging it down. And then you can go ahead and play it again, or you can move on to the rest of the editor actions. You can do it as many times as you'd like. And then that helps smooth out your balloon. Okay, so next you can go to change balloon color if you'd like. You can choose a color in your image already, or you can go around and click in the actual color box here. And once you have your color, and later on if you want to go change it, you can double click here and change it again. And you also have brush on change balloon color. I'm going to show you how that works. It works the same exact way, except now we have it hidden, so you can brush it on. So let's say I picked a different color. So that's how that works. You can just brush it on. You can also blur your balloon. You can add motion blur. A little bit or a lot. Make sure you have your actual balloon layer selected for that one. Otherwise, it will blur something else. Totally up to you how you want to edit your balloons. You can brighten the balloon, darken. You can add more color. Now keep in mind, each of these have different opacity settings right here. You can see this one is 50%, this one is 100. So you're more than welcome to change that opacity as you see fit. You can add balloon toning. This just kind of helps. It's very light. It just helps kind of add more warmth if you need to kind of help match it to your background. Coolness. So if you want cool, you're going to want to go into the blues to kind of match it more, depending on what your background is. And if you don't want it, you can select this eye here or just delete it. Totally up to you. There's also a warm up and cool down action as well. Now, if this pops up, it's just saying that the action was creating a clipping mask to only affect the balloon layer. All of these are clipped down. You see these arrows? They're clipped down to only the balloon layer. So that way it does not affect your background. So that's there as security. If it's already, if you're getting this, it's just telling you it's already clipped, so you don't need it to clip again. So you just press continue. Okay, so those are some of the actions to help edit your balloon. You're also more than welcome to go in and edit it on your own without the actions even further if you'd like, or you can move on to the string. Okay, so the next thing I'm going to want to do is I want string for my balloon. So I'm going to go ahead and select my, I'm going to show you the brushes first. So this is the string brush applicator and this is the string overlay. So the string brush, I'm going to press play. It's going to create a new layer just for your string. You have to create a new one for each and every string you apply. So if you're doing multiple balloons, then you're going to want multiple string as well. Okay, so once you have that, you can go up to your brushes and go down to where you have your balloon brushes installed. Here you have a freehand string here where you draw it on your own. If you hover over it, it'll display the title for you. And this one is for pen users, so like Wacom tablets. Otherwise, this one is kind of a little better for mouse users. They both kind of work great either way, but it's just a little bit tweaking for your liking. Okay, so now that we have our brush, we're going to want to make sure it's white. Usually balloon string is white, but you can change that if you want to. And then you can go ahead and kind of draw it on. You can either start from like the hand or start from the balloon. Totally up to you. There you go. So just a quick example of how you can draw that on. Okay, so in here, it's all string, except there is one studio catchlight brush. Now that is nice for if you want to add your own catchlight. So go ahead and apply. I'm going to go ahead and apply another balloon just to show you kind of a more darker color here. Press a check mark, and I'm going to select a white color and paint because this is going to be on its own layer because I'm going to show you how you can also blur the catchlight. Okay, so there we have a catchlight for the balloon that you can add on. And then you can also go down here to blur it if you'd like. And because we're working on its own layer, we're able to edit just that. Okay, so I just wanted to show you how that worked for the catchlight if you want to add one to your balloon. Okay, so I'm going to go back up to my layer here. And I will show you some of the other string. You can use your bracket tools on your keyboard to adjust it so it's smaller or whichever. Also, if you want to change the direction of it, like you can see here, it's obviously going through her neck. We don't want that. You can select brush here. And if you don't see the brush settings, you can go up to here and you can see brushes. And here we have our brush. We have our brushes here as well. Now, if you go over to brush settings, you'll be able to rotate it. See right here. And that works a little better. No, it's not going to be perfect. Okay, so there is a quick example of how you use the string brushes. Okay, so now that you have your brush layer, you can also go up to filter, liquify, or you can go up to the resizer and rotate it as well. I'm going to go up to liquify really quick, and you can kind of move it around. Right now you can't really see what's going on or where you want to direct it. So you can go down and you can go to show backdrop, and then that will help you. Okay, so you can kind of go ahead and move it around so it kind of goes more in your hand. Okay, select OK. That's how you use the brushes. I'm going to go ahead and add another string layer here and show you. You can also use the scripture ones as well. So you can go up to your brushes and select one that you like. This one says love. And again, you can adjust, you can rotate it. And you can also grab a soft brush, and using a black brush, you can come in and you can adjust it. You can erase the balloon off parts of your hand. And then you can kind of draw more to come out from her hand, like she's holding it. Okay, so there's a quick example on how to use that. You can also go in and edit your balloon string. You can add depth too. Kind of adds a little more depth for you. If you don't like that, you can select here and that will erase that for you. Okay, so now we know how to use our brushes. They are so much fun. And I'm also going to show you how to use the brush overlays, just in case you don't want to use the brushes. So you want to go to Apply Balloon String Overlay, select Continue, go to where your string are, and then you can select one that you wish to use. Once you have one, you can go ahead and select Place, and then you can kind of place it. And again, hold shift key or use the maintain proportions, or you don't have to at all. Okay, select the check mark here. And then you can go in and edit it again as you see fit to make it look like she's holding it, and you can liquify it, you can adjust it however you need to. And the same thing here, you can change the balloon string color, you can add depth to it. Whatever you like. And that's pretty much it. That's how you do it in Photoshop CC. And I'm going to quickly show you in Photoshop Elements. It's almost exactly the same. The brushes are right here. They're just in different areas a little bit. Okay, so you're going to want to go ahead and apply your balloon overlay. Now, I'm not going to go into too much detail with this because it literally is the exact same thing. You can resize, rotate. The check mark is right here for that. And again, you want to hold shift key. If you want, or you can unproportion it a little bit. Okay, select the check mark. And then make sure you have your actual layer clicked here if you want to flip it. Adjust the balloon as you need it. Okay, so that's how you add your balloon overlay. And then you can go ahead and do the same thing here and smooth out catch lights here. Press OK. Then you can go ahead and paint it on. Your brushes are right here. And then you have the size of your brush as well as the opacity here. And then if you go into brush settings, you'll be able to choose your hardness. So this is hard brush and this is soft. So that's where that is in PSE. And then you can go ahead and hide the layer by selecting the eye, or you can select the layer and press delete. Okay, and then you can also change the balloon color. Press continue. And then there you have your balloon color. You can blur your balloon. Again, make sure you have the layer actually selected. There you go. Again, everything is pretty much the exact same thing that I just went over. You can brighten balloon, darken, add balloon toning, warm it up. And you can double click here to change the color, the toning. Warm it up. And again, you have the same thing here, just press continue. Now, if you feel like it's not really making a big deal, it might be because it's the layer order. So you can adjust the layer order, and the same thing for PSE or for PSCC. See how that changed it a little bit? So it went above the color to help warm up that color. So if you're not seeing a difference, it might just because of the layer order. So one thing you can do is once you're done with it, you can just merge down so that we don't have to worry about it. That one's not even showing. But so just in case you're wondering why it's not doing anything, it might be because of the layer order. So you can cool balloon down, and then once you have all that, then you can go ahead and select your brush string layer. And then we will go to our brushes here. And here I have them installed. You can go ahead and select your Samurano balloon string. You want to make sure your balloon string is usually white. And you can go ahead and draw that on. I'm just showing you quickly. And then you can apply your balloon string overlays. Then select the check mark here. And then in your brush settings, that's where you'll have the angle for rotating it if you'd like to before you do that. Okay, so then you also have your string editor actions right here. Again, it's pretty much the exact same thing that we just went over in Photoshop, but I wanted to show you where to find all of the same things in this version. Obviously, this is a not so great image here. I would go in and edit it. I would adjust the balloon and all of that stuff. Okay, so that's pretty much how you use the balloon overlays and actions and brushes in Photoshop CC and Photoshop Elements. If you have any questions, let me know and we will be happy to help. Thank you so much for watching.